Hello, I am Rick Mercell, one of the founders of the Norva and vice president of the region for Bowery Presents and AEG Live. And today is the Norva's 20th anniversary.
So take us back 20 years, Rick. It was the Godfather of Soul. And why did you choose to open with James Brown 20 years ago?
We did not choose to open up with James Brown. So I don't know how many of you will remember, but we had 11 attempts to install the fire alarm system in the Norva. 11 attempts. Around the sixth attempt, we had someone steal the fire chip out of the elevator and cut some of the wires, and we thought someone was trying to sabotage us. What ended up happening is the company that was putting in the fire alarm, this was their very first time putting in a commercial fire alarm, so they had no idea what they were doing. So our first three shows that were all canceled was G Lovin' Special Sauce, String Cheese Incident, and The Wailers. All three of those had to go away or move. G Love ended up taking his guitar and playing out front of the Norva for the crowd that was out there. And then we all headed over to Crackers and had a really nice time that night. But that was supposed to be our first concert. G Love was actually going to come back in early May to help us celebrate that event, but obviously that's not going to happen. Mm-hmm. Maybe he'll come back later on in the year or in 2021. But James Brown was actually supposed to be our fourth artist. Serendipity took over and he became our opening act, which I think is spectacular and pretty special that James Brown was our opening act. Now, I guess what, it's about 10:30 right now. So 10:30, 20 years ago, I was sweating it out because we still hadn't received the okay from the fire marshal to open the venue yet.
How about that?
It wasn't until about 2 hours before the performance that we were given the go-ahead to do it. So mm-hmm. James Brown almost was not our first artist. It was about a two-hour window where it could have happened or could not have happened. James Brown told us, though, that he was going to play no matter what.
Okay. Very good. Now, the Norva was a movie theater, I guess, and theater in the past, and then it became a workout center, right?
Correct.
Then you guys took it over. What was it about the building that appealed to you, as well as the amenities, which turned out to be a real hallmark mm-hmm. and a favorite of performers to play the venue?
Okay, so the Norva was built in 1922. So we're 98 years old right now, so we'll be celebrating the 100th birthday of the building in 2 years. Mm-hmm. So that gives us something to look forward to. It was built as a vaudeville theater for the troops after World War I. And it was a spectacular theater on Granby Street. We bought the National in Richmond, and unbeknownst to us, the person who did the plaster work with these beautiful angel ladies that you can see in Chicha's backstage right now, those ladies were also in the National, so they were built by the same people. Mm-hmm. So when we decided, our first meeting was at the Sugar Plum Bakery, and at that meeting, we decided that we were going to do a concert venue, and we were going to do an amphitheater. Within a year, we had created the Harbor Center, the Intellis Pavilion, mm-hmm. And we were looking for a place to do what ended up as the Norva. The very first place we looked at was the Surf and Sand Movie Theater in Virginia Beach.
Okay.
They were originally going to move over into Laskin Road. They were going to do a whole project there, and that building was going to become vacant. We were going to take over that and turn that into the concert hall. That got delayed a little while, so by that time, hello. And I'm going to take a break for a coffee for a second.
Sir!